Food. Like everybody gets excited about food, right? When they're planning their wedding. There's a lot to pick from. Of course, there's the hors d'oeuvres for cocktail hour. There's the bar choices, specialty drinks. Oh my God, that's awesome. And then of course the food for the dinner or the lunch that all your guests will enjoy. You know, food is a really interesting thing. I think we get very caught up on what the choice of the menu will be, important, but food can help tell your story. I always also say that if you think about it, if you've got two cultures that are getting married together, you can represent the culture through food. You can also do experiences of food and not just a sit-down dinner. So let's take this as slow as we can in the little bit of time that I have. I want you to think about your menu as an extension of who you are as a couple. What are your favorite foods? What are some of the things you want your guests to experience? Do you want them to sit down and have a traditional three-course, four-course meal at your celebration? Or do you want them to get up and experience food around the perimeter of your space? That's an interesting question. There's no wrong or right. Now, here's another option. I'll give you the third option. You can serve a first course, which could be your salad or soup course. So guests have that, I like to call it structure. It's like their home place. They'd like to know that there's their table, their chair, their first course, and then have the main entree be experiences around the room. It could be multicultural. It could be one specific concept, which could be all Italian food. And then your dessert can come served to the table, or it can be more of a tapas style where your desserts are presented on different stands on the center of your table for guests to experience it all together collectively, family style pretty much. There's so many different things that you truly can do with food. But here's what you also need to do. If you're going to a hotel or a venue that has catering in-house, you can require a tasting. So you can experience the food firsthand before the actual celebration of your wedding. Now, your wedding is not the time to become a foodie. It's not the time to explore unique, crazy, over-the-top things for your guests. You have to be respectful of your guests, knowing that they may want something that's really simple that they feel comfortable with. So don't think too far outside the box. Now also, be very aware of dietary issues, allergies. You want to make sure you're accommodating the guests that you have seated at your celebration. And move it quickly. Rule of thumb, listen really carefully. Every course, either served or an experience and happening, every one of those moments should take 30 minutes and no more. That means served to the table, the guests will be eating that course or experiencing that moment, and the food then is cleared. If a restaurant or a caterer tells you it should be longer, that's only because they're making it all about them. Your food is a moment called comfort. It's a moment about making sure your guests feel comfortable eating so they can get up, get on that dance floor, and have fun. I do not want your guests stuck at the table eating a large majority of your celebration. So embrace food, have fun with food, come up with specialty drinks, name the specialty drinks something that's really kind of clever, or a nickname that one or the two or two of you have, because it personalizes the moment. Food is another way to personalize your celebration. Have fun with it, and certainly make it delicious